家好，我係 Michelle 朱曼舒，歡迎大家收聽我哋今日嘅嘉賓訪談嘅環節嘅。咁好多時咧，我見到好多嘅朋友咧都好中意學 ballroom dance 啊、拉丁舞啊。咁作為一種興趣咧，亦都可以係作為一種健身嘅運動嘅。咁如果中意跳舞嘅朋友咧，一定要留意我哋呢一節嘅環節啦。因為咧，我哋今日嘅節目咧非常之榮幸啊，請到咧就喺呢一方面咧有卓越成就嘅一位朋友上嚟同大家見面。佢分別咧係六次啊喺我哋加拿大咧喺呢一方面咧比賽咧係得到冠軍，同埋係代表加拿大咧係出賽國際賽，亦都係國際賽入邊咧係作為評判嘅，亦都係參加咗好多多部嘅電影入邊都參加演出嘅。咁佢咧就係阿靚仔華甸啦，華甸 ，welcome。
Thank you.
Yeah, welcome to our show. So, a lot of audience want to know about your story. So, can you tell us, actually, when and where did you start to learn how to dance?
I started dancing when I was 8 years old. Mm-hmm. It was in Ukraine, in Odessa. Yeah. This is south of Ukraine, right on the Black Sea. Mm-hmm. I was always interested about doing something like that, and one of the teachers said, I have a great potential, so I decided
to go for it. And also you're handsome, right?
Maybe that's one of the reasons. Mm-hmm, young and handsome. Yeah.
So actually at the time, so what motivates you to learn how to dance, and did you set a goal?
I like challenge, I like competition, and I decided to do something with it. Mm-hmm. So my
you
teacher said...
You wanted to be the champion, right?
Yes, I wanted to be the champion. I wanted to be the best what I could be in dancing. Yeah. I was talking to my teacher and I said I wanted to become professional one day. I wanted to go to the higher level.
Yeah, so finally you have it.
Yes, thank
you. 其實咧，阿華甸咧，咁同大家介紹咧，佢咧就係喺烏克蘭出世啦。咁八歲咧已經開始係學跳舞㗎。咁同埋咧，因為當時咧好多人都睇到佢有呢一種嘅 potential 啊。咁今時今日咧，的而且確咧，佢亦都係攞到咗佢想需要所得到嘅，攞到咗好高嘅獎項嘅。So, Awadin, when did you start your first competition?
The first competition is after probably 2 years of hard work. Mm-hmm. I started my first competition. It was a big event. It was a little bit unexpected for me. For the first time, I came first in
first
Ukraine.
Time.
Yes, so
really?
that was big. Mm-hmm. It was probably
what kind of a competition is that? What kind of award is that?
I was 10 years old, and it was in between 6-11 years old.
Yeah.
So I came first.
咁原來咧，佢經過兩年嘅努力咧，就喺九歲嘅時候已經係第一次參加咗比賽咧，同埋咧第一次比賽已經係攞到咗個比賽入邊嘅冠軍啊，所以話明咧佢係非常之有呢一方面嘅天分啊，咁所以咧亦都繼續咧係努力咧向呢一方面咧去發展嘅。So what other awards have you received after that?
After that, I received many awards. I became an amateur, the Ukrainian champion in tan dance and in standard in some years, and then in 1996, when I moved to Canada, 2 years later, we become Canadian representative to the World Professional Tan Dance Championship. Mm-hmm. So we represent Canada in all over the world.
Wow! Yes. Congratulations, right? It's not easy to to be the champion.
So. It's easy when something you like to do, you love doing, then you're ready to do sacrifices. You're willing to work hard. And you're enjoying the process.
So you're just talking about 10 dancers champion. So what's the meaning for that? What does it include?
In 10 dance, it includes two programs. Mm-hmm. So it includes standard and Latin. So 5 dances in standard. Mm-hmm. It's the waltz, tango, foxtrot, Viennese waltz, and quickstep, as well as 5 Latin dances, which is cha-cha, samba, rumba, paso doble, and jive.
Wow.
So that's 10 dances together. Lots of work. If some couple decide to do only standard, they're doing 5. Some Latin decide, some couple decide to do only Latin, they're doing another 5. Couldn't make a decision because everything went well.
Yeah.
So that's why I did 10.
Wow, congratulations again. So, 咁阿華甸咧經過不停嘅努力咧，咁終於咧佢係嚟咗加拿大之後啊，咁咧就頭先亦都提到啦，咁喺六次咧喺加拿大啊，係專業嘅比賽入邊咧，佢六次咧係攞到加拿大嘅冠軍，咁同埋咧係代表加拿大咧係參加呢個國際嘅比賽，同埋咧係得到咗咧係十項嘅全能啊。咁所謂十項全能咧，頭先阿華甸都介紹過啦，就係有5項咧就係ballroom dance 標準舞嘅，咁而另外5項咧就係拉丁舞啊，咁佢分別咧喺十項唔同嘅項目入邊咧，佢全部都係得到冠軍嘅，咁所以真係非常之犀利。我哋今日亦都係非常之榮幸啦，可以喺依度咧係訪問阿華甸嘅。So you just talk about 10 dances. It means usually little students they learn dance. Is that what they will learn this kind of dance?
From the beginning, I would suggest to learn or like we're teaching them on the concept of the dance. It's how to move body, how to listening to the music, and it doesn't matter it's international or it's American, because waltz. everywhere it's a waltz tango, everywhere it's a tango, so just difference in the steps, yeah. But techniques more or less the same.
Yeah. So actually, when did you start your teaching career?
The teaching career I started when I was 15 years old. Mm-hmm. So I've started
15
teaching.
Years old?
Yes, I started teaching when I was 15. Mm-hmm. And by the age, the 19, 20, I already had three studios back home.
Oh.
And mostly we teach kids back home because it was popular.
Why?
Kids wanted to be the best. They have a drive and they have a good potential. So mm-hmm. In 2 years we brought them up so high they become in the final of the world championships.
Oh, they all want to be champions one day.
Yes.
So actually, 咁啊，阿華甸咧，其實咧，十五歲已經開始咧，就喺烏克蘭啊嚇，咁佢已經開始係教學生噶啦。咁同埋咧，喺短短嘅時間咧，喺烏克蘭咧已經係有三間嘅學校啊，係教授一啲嘅小朋友噶。咁點解佢當時咁中意教授小朋友 ？Is that teacher is a So is that you?
It's me, yes, a little bit younger age.
How old were you then?
I was probably 8 years old.
8 years old?
Yeah, 8, 9 years old.
咁啊，頭先我哋睇到咧，原來華甸咧細嗰時啦，或者都個樣都好 Q 啊嚇。咁佢咧就咁頭先亦都講到啦，佢喺烏克蘭嘅時候咧，喺十五歲已經係教小朋友嘅。咁因為烏克蘭咧有好多嘅小朋友咧，佢哋都好想咧係參加比賽，好似華甸咁樣做冠軍啦。咁所以咧，咁當時佢喺烏克蘭咧亦都開咗啲學校，開始教學生啦。So when did you start teaching in Canada?
In Canada, I started teaching in 1997.
Mm-hmm, 1997. So what age group of students are you teaching?
We're teaching everyone starting probably from 18 years old with mm-hmm. no limit.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
So what levels of lessons are you offering?
We're offering from beginners to advanced. Mm-hmm. So you don't need to have a partner, you don't need to know how to dance, you just need to come in and have a little bit desire to start learning and we can pick it up from there. Mm-hmm. Usually people think I have two left feet. If they come in, I have a two right one in a closet, so we're gonna exchange them.
No, okay. 咁如果大家中意學跳舞咧，咁頭先阿華甸都話咧，即係原來咧都即係如果係可以揾到阿華甸咧教你咧，我覺得咧即係非常之榮幸啊，因為佢都係喺呢方面咧係非常之有呢個成就啦。So I have some pictures here, Wardeen. We want to share with our audience. So can you explain to us what is this picture for?
This is a picture of standard dancing on a competition.
我哋一齊咧，不如個camera咧就 zoom 近啲睇下我哋阿華甸咧呢啲嘅相咧，其實咧係非常之珍貴嘅。So this is during the competition?
Yes, that's during competition.
咁呢個咧就係當時咧佢參加比賽嘅一啲嘅相啦。咁亦都我哋咧就喺呢個相入邊咧都睇到啦。其實咧佢呢一啲嘅比賽咧，咁啊非常之投入啊，同埋咧就係頭先我哋提到嘅。就係呢啲嘅比賽咧，係可以係代表到我哋加拿大咧係參加國際賽嘅六次咧，係得到我哋加拿大咧全國嘅冠軍。咁咧就係代表我哋加拿大咧係參加比賽嘅。咁啊有好多唔同嘅 article 啊文章咧都有訪問過啊華甸啦。咁呢一個咧就係喺我哋大家都好熟悉嘅一啲嘅雜誌上面咧，亦都有一啲訪問啊華甸嘅文章啦，一啲嘅 article 㗎。咁咧亦都有好多唔同嘅，因為時間嘅關係，我哋都唔可以喺呢度咧全部 show 俾大家睇啦。咁啊好啦，咁啊講到教學生，好多人都好想知道啦。So actually for teaching, right? So what kind of competition and do you recommend and encourage your students to participate?
We have a few events. We have a showcases.
Yes.
Like we have an event in the studio, what we call spotlight presentation. It's the first level.
Yeah.
Then we have a twice a year showcases,
uh-huh.
and after that competitions. So mm-hmm. any competition what exists, the more competition the students doing,
mm-hmm.
the better they become.
So actually, how many kind of competitions are there available on the market?
There is lots of competition, different level. It's a bronze, in mm-hmm. competition in bronze, competition in silver, competition in gold. There is amateur events. There is a pro-am event when professional dancing with a student.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, it's getting very, very popular. And of course, there is a professional events.
Yeah.
Professional events could be the same as amateur in Latin, mm-hmm. in standard, in international style, in American style.
Mm.
So there is a lot.
It's a
big variety.
Yes.
You need to be able to dance.
Yeah, and you were the champions for professional, not amateur. So we just want to verify, right? Because there were a lot of other people, they said they were champions, and people got confused because there were a lot of different kind of competition. So
you
know, we have a lot of people who say, I'm the champion, I'm the champion. You know, there are a lot of different kinds of competition. So you have amateur, which is a 业余的比赛. 其他啲咧就係專業嘅比賽就係 professional 嘅，好似滑冰呢啲咧就係 professional 嘅比賽係得到冠軍。咁而另外仲有一種咧就係 amateur and professional combine together is pole M right？Yes，it's prime。Yes，it's prime。咁有一種嘅比賽咧就係一個係專業嘅啦，同埋一個個學生咁兩個咧就 combine 埋一齊嘅比賽就叫做 pole M 嘅。咁所以咧其實咧真有好多種唔同嘅比賽咧可以係俾我哋去選擇嘅。So can you briefly explain to us what kind of what type of dances are there available now?
There is availability of any kind of dance. There is a social activity, there is international, there is American, there is a big variety, big spectrum of dancing.
Okay, if our audience have some questions, how they can reach you?
They can reach me at 416-894-5315.
So where's your studio?
The studio, we have a 3 location. Yeah. One of the closest location, if they're gonna go on website, www.dancestudio1.ca, they can check it out. 3 location, the closest probably is Victoria Park and McNichol.
咁好啦，咁啊大家咧有興趣咧就可以直接上佢哋嘅 website 咧係去詢問更多嘅詳情。咁今日我哋好多謝阿華丁咧上嚟接受我哋訪問。Thank you so much, Wardine.
My pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.